Attorney General, thanks for your time. Can you start by telling me why you filed this lawsuit, why you feel like it's necessary?
Yeah, I just fundamentally don't believe that in government force masking of our kids. This lawsuit's really about returning that power back to parents and families who can make those decisions. And the burden of proof just simply hasn't been met by these school boards. There's no widespread study that shows that masking is effective. The good news is that kids have a very low risk of contracting, transmitting, or getting seriously ill from COVID. That's good. But what we do know is there's a growing body of evidence that shows there are severe complications, not only with learning, but emotional and psychological issues of kids being forced to wear masks all day long. And it's really a fight about who we're going to be as a country. Do we value freedom in individuals being able to make these decisions, or government forcing people to wear masks all day long? So we think it's a very important lawsuit, and we filed it today. Again, we want to return that power back to families and to parents.
You quote the science throughout this filing. What science are you referring to?
That kids have a very low risk of contracting and transmitting, getting seriously ill. I mean, here's the good news. Every death is a tragedy, but the good news is that because of COVID, there have been no children under the age of 10 who've died. There have been 5 under the age of 18. Those are significantly low numbers. That's a positive. It certainly doesn't justify forcing every child, you know, the 1.2 plus million children in the state to wear masks all day long. The science just simply doesn't support it. And in fact, of the hospitalizations related to COVID, 1 in 200,000 is a child. And so again, you balance that with what we know are the detrimental psychological and emotional impacts. There's a study, a German study that shows 68% of kids have had complications or complaints about wearing a mask all day long. So again, when you balance the facts and the science here, we just think that individuals ought to be able to make this decision, parents ought to be able to make this decision, not government bureaucrats.
Immediately after this lawsuit was filed, we have local doctors who run infectious disease for our children's hospital here who came out and refuted a lot of the claims, saying that that's not necessarily the case. They do believe masking works, and they have been strong advocates for masking universally in the classroom. Does it bother you at all that the great majority of the doctors treating kids here locally in Kansas City don't agree with the science that you quote?
Well, the science and the facts are the science and the facts. They can have their opinions, but I'm quoting actual facts. There are 0 deaths under the age of 10. There are 5 under the age of 18. Kids, every serious study will show you that kids have a very, and this is a good thing, because not all viruses are the same. Kids, you know, in some viruses can transmit it easily, not with COVID. That's a good thing. And so then the question is, who gets to make the decision of forcing a child to wear a mask all day long? Should that be a school district, or should a parent be able to make that decision? That's all this wouldn't ban kids from wearing masks. It just says that those families get to decide how they want to handle that situation.
We looked at some of the data nationally. 22% of the new cases of COVID-19 right now are in kids.
Yeah, well, the studies would also show that the Delta variant may be more contagious, but the good news is, well, the health outcomes are similar, that you're not seeing, you know, kids becoming more seriously ill because of the Delta variant. That's the science. Again, those are the facts. And so there's really no justification for forcing this masking. More kids are at serious risk of influenza than COVID. Now, that's not true for every age group, but it is for kids. And again, these are the facts and these are the science. If people want somebody, you know, if you're vaccinated and want to wear a mask outside by yourself walking around a track, this is America. Go do that. But you shouldn't be forcing the government for other people to do that.
We had a local school district, the Turner School District in Kansas City, Kansas. Different side, but still same in the metro. They started the school year with a recommendation for students to wear masks. Well, not even a week into school, there are hundreds of kids, teachers who are under quarantine. It's the same story in Missouri. We have countless cases. School districts are concerned about keeping up with this. So we've had school districts reverse course. I know in this filing you talk about it needs to be renewed every 30 days by the school board. What makes that a different decision than a school board deciding for a semester?
Yeah, that's a good question. So there are basically two arguments in the lawsuit, or two causes of action, essentially. The one is they fall under the new state law that would require them to renew this kind of decision every 30 days like a local government would. The second one is that this is based on these decisions have been arbitrary and capricious. They're not based on science. They're not based on facts. And I'll give you a good example. You know, we've been obviously standing on guard too with local governments doing this. In St. Louis City, for example, they have a mask mandate. Their cases are up 11%. In St. Louis County, when we've been successful in defeating that mask mandate, their cases are down 18%. So again, all we can do is point to the facts and point to the science. And I think there's a great deal of fear mongering that's happening right now. And I think it's a very dangerous road for us to go down, to try to scare people into your point of view and the facts and science don't support it. And we're standing up to that. That's what this lawsuit's about. Again, if you want to wear a mask at school, that's fine. If you want to send your kids to school in masks, that's a parent's decision. It shouldn't be the government dictating that for everybody.
The whole state of Missouri has high transmission right now. Does that change your opinion at all?
Well, again, this hasn't been widely reported, but I'm glad you asked the question. Actually, Missouri is number two in the last 14 days in the decline of COVID cases across the country. I don't see a lot of reporting on that. So the reality is, I think we just need to get the facts and the science out there, and when people can make their own decisions. Look, we're going to be living with COVID for a while. There are going to be peaks and valleys here. The question is, who do we want to be as a country? Do we want to live in some futuristic dystopian biomedical security state? Or do we want to live in the freest country on earth, knowing what the facts and the science are, again, that kids are at very, very low risk? Do we want the government making that decision for all those kids? Or do we want the parents making that decision for those kids? And so that's what this lawsuit's all about.
In the filing, you say the cure cannot be worse than the disease. Do you think masks are worse than COVID?
There's a growing body of evidence that would suggest that. I just cited the German study that showed 68% of kids have the complaints about depression, anxiety. There are severe, makes learning and schooling much more difficult. So those are things that are real. And you balance that with, again, the very low risk of kids actually contracting this in a serious way, where serious health consequences or death are really in play. I think people get to balance that. And so I don't subscribe to trying to scare people into my point of view. I'm just allowing people, my view is that people ought to be able to make those own their own decisions.
Attorney General, you've quoted the German study. I know there's one from the UK that's mentioned. Did you consult any local doctors, school districts, health departments on this, particularly any in the Kansas City area before filing?
We've been in contact with a lot of folks. And as this case moves forward, there'll be experts that'll be called. But we've combed through all the relevant studies. And I just think once people learn what the facts are, that's good news. Again, any death is a tragedy, but there have been no kids under the age of 10 that have died of COVID. There are only five under the age of 15. They're one in 200,000 hospitalizations related to COVID are children. So those are the facts. And I think people can make their own decisions if they want to wear a mask all day long or not. And by the way, the CDC has a study showing that masks are, there's no real measurable benefit, especially for kids. And so again, these are the facts.
Where is that study?
I would be happy to get it to you. I think our communications office just tweeted it out. So we'll make sure you have a copy of it.
At last check, the CDC, the American Academy of Pediatrics, our local and county health departments have all practically unanimously supported universal masking in the classroom.
Well, I would point out that 90% of the school districts in the state don't require it. And that it's unfortunate that some of our health bureaucracies have become really political. And it's unfortunate. I mean, it was just a few weeks ago, the CDC said, if you've been vaccinated, you don't need to wear a mask. And then they changed that point of view. So I think there's an erosion of trust, which is unfortunate. So all we're trying to do is lay out the facts, all of the serious studies just simply don't support these decisions. And then ultimately what this is about is allowing parents to make the decision. This doesn't ban masks in schools. This would just say that the government can't force every child to wear a mask and that parents get to make that decision. I trust the people to make their own good decisions.
I only have two more. It says that you seek to protect the welfare of kids across the state of Missouri. How do you believe this filing protects kids?
Well, I think there, again, if you look at the science and you look at the data, there are serious impacts for kids being forced to wear masks all day long. There are studies that will show that. And so, again, parents get to balance that with the, you know, very low likelihood that their child will get seriously ill. Look, we can't control for every risk factor out there, but the good news is that this virus is not particularly transmittable among kids. And that those, again, that's the facts and those are the science. That's the science.
As far as our local health officials, a lot of them have expressed a little bit of frustration at being at this point in the pandemic. It doesn't seem to be slowing down. There's concern about increased numbers in our children's hospital of kids who do have COVID. Maybe not a ton, but they feel like death is not the only consequence here. What is your message for healthcare providers across the state who don't agree? They feel kind of tired and like they don't have much support.
Well, they are appreciated. There's no question about that. But I think we have to understand what this virus is all about. We're going to be living with it for a while. It's not going away next week. And so the question is, how do we want to live with the virus? You got vaccines that are widely available. People can choose, you know, to make those decisions. We know that masks aren't particularly effective. So what kind of society are we going to be? I don't want to live in some futuristic dystopian biomedical security state. America's the freest country in the history of the world. People can make their decisions. We know a lot more than we did a year ago. And so healthcare workers are doing great, very important work. But when it comes to the government forcing masks on kids, they haven't met their burden of proof as far as that being effective. What we do know is that the science will tell you and the studies will show that kids are having adverse, you know, health consequences from that. They're typically dirty masks. You've got kids who are psychological and emotional problems from it, and learning's more difficult. So again, people can weigh those decisions. I trust individuals and parents to make those decisions, families to make those decisions. I don't think you should have a one-size-fits-all government solution here.